Hello students, I am T.N. Jnaneshwara. In the previous class, I had introduced parts of speech to you. In this session, we shall discuss the parts of speech in detail. The learning objectives of this session is to help students to understand parts of speech. After watching this video, you will be able to identify the parts of speech in sentences. The noun. A noun is a word that denotes the name of a person, place, thing, or idea. Ashoka was a wise king. The rose smells sweet. The police dispersed the crowd. His courage won him honor. Here, Ashoka is a proper noun. King and rose are common nouns. Crowd is a collective noun. Courage and honor are abstract nouns. The adjective. An adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun. He is an honest man. Here, honest is an adjective of quality. I ate some rice. Here, some is an adjective of quantity. The hand has five fingers. Here, five is an adjective of number. That boy is industrious. Here, that is a demonstrative adjective. Whose book is this? Here, whose is an interrogative adjective. I saw it with my own eyes. Here, own is an emphasizing adjective. What an idea! Here, what is an exclamatory adjective. Articles a, an, and the are demonstrative adjectives. The pronoun. A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. You see personal pronouns in this table. I and we are first person pronouns. You is the second person pronoun. He, she, it, and they are third person pronouns. When self is added to my, your, him, etc., we get compound personal pronouns. In the example, I hurt myself, myself is a reflexive pronoun. But in the example, I will do it myself, myself is an emphatic pronoun. In the example, that is the red fort, that is a demonstrative pronoun. One must not prize oneself. Here, one is an indefinite pronoun. Each of the boys gets a prize. Here, each is a distributive pronoun. I met Hari, who had just returned. Here, who is a relative pronoun. Whatever he does well. Here, whatever is a compound relative pronoun. Who are you? Here, who is an interrogative pronoun. What? You don't know Rama? Here, what is an exclamatory pronoun. The verb. A verb is a word used to express an action or state. Verbs are mainly classified into three categories: main verbs, auxiliary verbs, and modal verbs. Some examples for main verbs are walk, run, eat, drink, read, write, play, jump, swim, etc. The verbs be, have, and do are called auxiliary verbs. The verbs will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, must, ought to, used to, need, and dare are called modal verbs. Forms of verbs. A verb can take five forms. In this table, V1 is the base form of the verb, V2 is the past form, V3 is the past participle, V4 is the singular form of the verb, and V5 is the present participle of the verb. Most verbs like kill have a past tense and past participle with ed. They are called regular verbs, but many of the most frequent verbs like cut, beat, bleed, etc. are irregular. The adverb. An adverb is a word used to add something to the meaning of a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. He comes here daily. Here, daily is an adverb of time. He often makes mistakes. Here, often is an adverb of frequency. Go there. Here, there is an adverb of place. The boy works hard. Here, hard is an adverb of manner. The sea is very stormy. Here, very is an adverb of degree or quantity. Surely you are mistaken. Here, surely is an adverb of affirmation. I do not know him. Here, not is an adverb of negation. He therefore left school. Here, therefore is an adverb of reason. Where is Abdul? Here, where is an interrogative adverb. This is the reason why I left. Here, why is a relative adverb. The preposition. A preposition is a word used with a noun or a pronoun to show how the person or thing denoted by the noun or pronoun stands in relation to something else. ನೌನ್ ಅಥವಾ ಪ್ರೊನೌನ್ ಯಾವ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಅಥವಾ ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ಸೂಚಿಸ್ತದೋ ಆ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಅಥವಾ ವಸ್ತುವಿಗೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಅಥವಾ ವಸ್ತುವಿನೊಂದಿಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧವನ್ನು ಕಲ್ಪಿಸುವ ಪದವೇ ಪ್ರಿಪೋಸಿಷನ್. ಅ ಗರ್ಲ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಅ ಟ್ರೀ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಿಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಹಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮಾರ್ನ್ ಟಿಲ್ ನೈಟ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟಿಲ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೋಸಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಹಿ ಕಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ನೈಫ್. Here with is a preposition of agency. He fought with courage. Here with is a preposition of manner. The boy with red hair. Here with is a preposition of possession. He died of fever. Here of is a preposition of reason. Cloth is sold by the yard. Here by is a preposition of measure. We travelled by train. Here by is a preposition of transport. For all his wealth, he is not content. Here for is a preposition of contrast. His skills come from practice. Here from is a preposition of origin. The conjunction. A conjunction is a word used to join words or sentences. Either take it or leave it. Either and or are correlative conjunctions. He visited not only Agra but also Delhi. Not only and but also are compound conjunctions. Many things have happened since I saw you. Here, since is a conjunction of time. As he was not there, I spoke to his brother. Here, as is a conjunction of reason. He held my hand lest I should fall. Here, lest is a conjunction of purpose. He was so tired that he could scarcely stand. Here, that is a conjunction of consequence. Rama will go if Hari goes. Here, if is a conjunction of condition. I will not see him though he comes. Here, though is a conjunction of concession. He is stronger than Rustum. Here, than is a conjunction of comparison. The interjection. An interjection is a word which expresses some sudden feeling. Hello, what are you doing there? Hurrah, we have won the game. Alas, he is dead. Hello, hurrah. And alas are interjections. Let us recapitulate what we have learnt in this session. A noun is a word that denotes the name of a person, place, thing, or idea. An adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun. A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. A verb is a word used to express an action or state. An adverb modifies the meaning of a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. A preposition shows the relation of something to the other. A conjunction joins two words or sentences. An interjection expresses a sudden feeling or emotion. Now let me check your understanding. I will ask some multiple choice questions. Please try to answer the questions. Question number 1. Which of the following is not a kind of noun? Option A, common noun. Option B, proper noun. Option C, improper noun. Option D, collective noun. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is improper noun. Question number 2. Articles are dash. Option A, demonstrative pronouns. Option B, demonstrative adjectives. Option C, relative adverbs. Option D, prepositions of possession. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is demonstrative pronouns. Question number 3. We traveled dash train. Option A, in. Option B, by. Option C, on. Option D, from. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is option B, by. Question number 4. In the following sentence, the italicized word is, the sentence is, he comes here daily. Options. Option A, adverb of time. Option B, preposition of time. Option C, conjunction of time. Option D, indefinite pronoun. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is adverb of time. Question number 5. In the following sentence, the italicized word is dash. The sentence is, hello, what are you doing there? Options. Option A, preposition. Option B, article. Option C, conjunction. Option D, interjection. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is interjection. This is the list of books and websites I referred to prepare this video. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.